Good morning, family. Good to see you this morning. If you'd stand with me. Now, can you hear me outside? Can you raise your hand if you hear me outside? Although I don't see.
Christina's waving.
They're outside. They're waiting. I can't see anybody, which is strange. All right, we're good. Fantastic. I got to say, missed you last week, but didn't Deanna and the team do a great job leading worship last week? It was wonderful to be a part of that, to let her lead. She's just grown to such a great worship leader. Just a wonderful time. We're glad we're back, and I have to just announce it because as a father, I am just to the moon. I get to worship with my whole family. My son is now playing drums today, Ethan Bender. I got my daughter, Caitlin, my wife, Melissa. My heart is full. So I'm going to try my best not to cry today as I'm leading these songs. Normally, that's a struggle anyway. But I want you to be able to participate with us, though. We've spent a lot of time practicing. This is the part now where you get to join in with us. And we're going to sing and praise God this morning because we get to hear a wonderful message of what God is doing all throughout the world. The Convoy of Hope. We have an opportunity to respond to the Lord with our tithes and our offerings and missions giving, and that we get an opportunity both in the receiving of God's word and our response to it, as well as praising his name. But before we do all of that, I would like you just to prepare yourself with us. If you would, let's bow our heads together. If you find yourself at home or in this place, Father, may you be glorified today. I pray, Lord, that our response to you would be a sacrifice of praise. God, that we would acknowledge you as King in our lives, that we would truly believe it. Father, we'd forget what's behind us and look to you right now, knowing, Lord, that you will guide us through whatever it is, whatever valley we are going through, you will walk with us through it all. And we thank you, Lord God, that you have a plan for our lives. But in this moment, I pray that we would take all of the focus off of ourselves and we place it on you, Jesus, that you would be the center of all that we do. And it's in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said, amen. Let's worship the Lord this morning. This is the house of the Lord. We want to celebrate. Come on. We're going to sing praises to him. He is King. He is Lord. He's our Savior. Come on. We worship the God who was, we worship the God who is, we worship the God who evermore will be. 'Cause he opened the prison doors, he parted the raging sea. My God, he holds the victory. From that grave, my God, still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. Shout out to praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. Together. Oh, we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, but now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by his grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Let's do that. We were the beggars, now we're royalty. The prisoners, now we're running free. today, and we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place, and we won't be quiet. Come on. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today, and we won't be quiet. We shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. Oh, shout out your praise. Yeah, we shout out your praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Is there joy in the house of the Lord this morning? Come on. Amelia, why don't you come on up, girl? We're going to hear a word of the Lord this morning through Amelia.
Good morning, church family. Today I'd like to read 2 Corinthians 5:20. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though we were making a prayer appear through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. Let's continue worshiping the Lord together.
The freedom I'm living in.
me. You are my deliverer, the freedom I'm living in. Oh, you are my deliverer, you are my promised land. Sing, you are my deliverer, the freedom I'm living in. Oh, you are my deliverer, you are my promised land. One last time. You are my deliverer, the freedom I'm living in. God, you are my deliverer, you are my promised land.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you,
Mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. Of the goodness of God.
That church. I've got good news for you. Whether you believe it or not, it's true. All your life, He's been faithful. He is preparing you not for this life, He's preparing you for the life to come. Whatever we go through right now is to ready us for eternity. That we want to give to Him a heart of gratitude, of love, response of joy. Hallelujah.
Sing these songs as I often do. Every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands to praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah. Nothing else fit for a king, except for hearts singing alleluia, alleluia. I've got one response. I've got just one move.
Let's stretch your arms.
With my arms stretched wide, I will worship you. So I throw up my hands, praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much. Your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of me. again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but nothing else fit for a king, except for hearts singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Nothing else fit for a king. I throw up my hands, throw up my hands.
Yourself to worship him right now. Sing your new song to him. Lift your voice. This is what I'm talking about in a sacrifice of praise. I know it's awkward. I know it's hard. But your Creator, your Heavenly Father wants to hear you sing because it frees you. It empowers you. And it gives glory to him. Hallelujah, Lord God. You are worthy, Father. My soul sings to you. Heavenly Father, you are worthy of praise and glory and honor. You are a strong fortress. You are our provider. You are our healer. You are our rock. Jesus, you are our master and friend. The stone rejected, it's now the cornerstone. You are all that we need. God, you are all that we want. Oh, Jesus. You've always been faithful. You are always good. We are the redeemed, and we are saying so, that you are forever, you are eternal. God, you are love. You don't have qualities of love, you are love. And so in this moment, Lord, we respond to you. Out of the gratitude and the abundance of joy in our hearts, we celebrate your goodness. We say thank you. This place, God, where we find ourselves, I pray, Lord, that we, God, we'd be able to respond and know Jesus, who you are. And I pray for those, Lord, that may not know you personally right now. We're finding it very difficult to know how to respond, and I just want to encourage you. All God requires is you to say that Jesus is my Savior. Believe in him. Ask forgiveness for your sins. And trust. He takes that from you. And begin to live a life defined by his word. And right now, we're just responding to that. We're saying, God, I know I'm not good enough. I know I can't do things right on my own. Holy Spirit, come. Fill me. Renew me. Out of myself. I'm so selfish. Let me see what it is that you're doing and come and be a part of it. And in this moment, God, I pray that we would receive what it is that you have. Allow us, Lord, our focus never to deter from you, your face, as we continue in the service of worship. May be glorified in Jesus' name. Everyone said, amen.